This is Captain Philip with Airworthy Tours, your guide in the sky. And today we're going to the ATL. That's right, Atlanta, Georgia. Now we have a lot to cover in today's tour. So let's get started. The city of Atlanta was founded on December 29, 1847. It was founded to be a railroad hub and link between the Port of Savannah and the Midwest. By 1860, the city had a population of almost 10,000. During the Civil War, Atlanta served as a major supply depot and the keystone of Confederate rail transportation east of the Mississippi River, thus making it a prime target for Union forces under General William Tecumseh Sherman. During Sherman's decisive march to the sea, Atlanta faced a 5-week siege and bombardment before being captured on September 1st, 1864. Our first stop is the iconic Georgia State Capitol building. After the Civil War, Atlanta was quickly rebuilt and became the capital of Georgia in 1868. The Georgia State Capitol building was constructed in 1889 and has the familiar neoclassical architectural styles that you see in many of the other state capitals. The Gold Dome Capitol building has become a staple of the Atlanta skyline. However, the Capitol's dome consisted of 10 until 1959, when it was covered with gold leaf, originating from Dahlonega, Georgia. Atop the Capitol is a 26-foot-tall, 1,600-pound copper statue of a woman with a torch in one hand and a sword in the other. She's affectionately known as Miss Freedom. Right next to the state capitol is City Hall, headquarters of the Atlanta City Government. Constructed in 1930, is actually Atlanta's fourth City Hall to be built. A quick thing to note is that while the city of Atlanta has the 37th largest population at 488,000 people, the Atlanta metropolitan area is the 9th largest in the country with over 6 million people. Our next stop is Midtown, one of Atlanta's three financial districts. So now's a good time to talk about the economy of the ATL. According to Forbes, the Atlanta Metro has an economy or gross metro product of $379 billion, making it the 10th largest in the country and in the top 20 cities in the world. Atlanta is also the headquarters of many global corporations, including the Coca-Cola Company, Home Depot, AT&T, Chick-fil-A, UPS, and Delta Airlines. Speaking of Delta, Atlanta's Hartsfield-Jackson is the world's busiest airport. And between 2015 to 2019, it serviced over 100 million passengers annually, with over 700,000 planes taking off and landing. Another financial area is Buckhead, Atlanta's wealthiest district. Ahead is the world-famous or infamous Lenox Mall. Atlanta over the years has become a growing fashion-forward city. However, Buckhead is seeking to break away from Atlanta to become its own city, which is a topic that we will discuss in our next video. Next is the Georgia World Congress Center, or the GWCC for short. This convention center encompasses some 3.9 million square feet in exhibition space, making it the third largest convention center in the United States. And it hosts more than a million visitors each year. The center is operated on behalf of the state by the Georgia World Congress Center Authority, which was chartered in 1971 by the Georgia General Assembly to develop an international trade and exhibition center in Atlanta. The authority later developed the Georgia Dome, Centennial Olympic Park, and Mercedes-Benz Stadium, which replaced the Georgia Dome. Our next stop is Centennial Olympic Park. This 22-acre park sits right in the middle of downtown Atlanta. The park was completed in time for the 1996 Summer Olympic Games, which were hosted in Atlanta. Atlanta beat out Athens, Belgrade, Manchester, Melbourne, and Toronto to get the games and was selected on September 18, 1990 in Tokyo, Japan. The centennial portion of the name is because the 1996 Summer Games were the 100th anniversary of the modern Olympic Games that began in Athens, Greece in 1896. The centerpiece of the park are the Fountain of Rings, The fountain is surrounded by flags representing the host countries of each Summer Olympics preceding the 1996 Games, and 8 65-foot-tall light towers, reminiscent of classical Greek marker columns. The 1996 Summer Olympics were special because it was the first time in modern Olympic history that all 197 recognized National Olympic Committees were represented at the Games. A total of 24 countries made their Olympic debuts in Atlanta, including 11 former republics of the Soviet Union. Unfortunately, tragedy would occur during the 1996 Summer Olympics. On July 27, 1996, domestic terrorist Eric Rudolph detonated a pipe bomb in Centennial Park, killing two and wounding over 100. Centennial Park is flanked by many of Atlanta's well-known tourist attractions, attractions that we'll be taking a look at very soon. Below is Skyview Atlanta. This 20-story Ferris wheel features 42 climate-controlled gondolas, providing guests with breathtaking panoramic views of downtown and the surrounding metropolitan area. Opened in July of 2013, is the latest addition to Atlanta's impressive skyline. Ahead is the CNN Center, the headquarters of CNN, which is another major company based in Atlanta. CNN, which stands for the Cable News Network, was launched by media mogul Ted Turner in Atlanta on June 1, 1980, as the world's first 24-hour all-news network. CNN Headline News was the first network to broadcast the show from the center and started live programming at 6 a.m. Eastern Standard Time of that same day. The main newsrooms and studios for several of CNN's news channels are located in the building. In May 2020, it was a focal point for weeks of protest, sparked by the murder of George Floyd. The CNN Center is a huge complex at 1.2 million square feet. Outside of the studio, the building also hosts a large food court, retail shops, and an Omni hotel. However, recently the building was sold to a real estate company in Florida for an undisclosed amount in July of 2021. In total, there are over 24 media companies based in Atlanta, including Turner Studios, which headquarters a number of cable channels such as Cartoon Network, True TV, TBS, and TNT. The facility also houses Studio J, where the taping of the wildly popular Inside the NBA takes place. With the selling of the CNN Center, many of the CNN operations will be moved to this facility. Next is the World of Coca-Cola, which is a museum showcasing the history and production of the iconic soft drink. The Coca-Cola drink was first invented and introduced in 1886. And yes, the very first Coca-Cola products contained cocaine, about 9 milligrams per glass. The substance was touted at the time as a substitute for alcohol and was said to cure opium addiction. Go figure. The substance was removed from Coca-Cola in 1903. Today, the Coca-Cola company has a product portfolio of more than 3,500 beverages and 500 brands, including sodas, energy drinks, and soy-based drinks. Of the 57 billion servings of all kinds of non-water beverages drank each day, over 3% or 1.9 billion are drinks trademarked or licensed by Coca-Cola, making it the most widely distributed product on the planet, available everywhere except in Cuba and North Korea. Our next stop is the Georgia Aquarium. The aquarium got its start after being funded mostly by a $250 million donation from Home Depot co-founder Bernie Marcus. The aquarium opened in November of 2005. The Georgia Aquarium is the third largest aquarium in the world, housing more than 100,000 sea creatures and containing up to 11 million gallons of water. Its whale shark exhibit alone holds 6.3 million gallons of water, making it the largest aquarium exhibit on the planet. The Georgia Aquarium is the only aquarium outside Asia to exhibit a whale shark, and one of four aquariums in the world to display manta rays. Other notable species include 12 bottlenose dolphins, beluga whales, California sea lions and sea otters, African penguins, and of course, sharks. Each year, these animals eat up to 500,000 pounds of food. The Georgia Aquarium sees up to 2 million visitors a year. Now, let's take a quick lunch pit stop, because we can't talk about Atlanta without mentioning the food. If you're in downtown, make sure to check out Atlanta's Breakfast Club, where you can get some of the best Southern-style chicken and waffles, second only to Roscoe's. Atlanta is the chicken capital of the world, and in particular when it comes to chicken wings. There are over 100 places to get wings in Metro Atlanta, with many of my friends from the A swearing by American Deli. And they are not wrong about that recommendation. Speaking of chicken, our next stop is the Chick-fil-A College Football Hall of Fame, which opened in 2014 at a cost of $70 million. The College Football Hall of Fame is 95,000 square feet, containing three floors, five themed galleries, and over 50 interactive exhibits, including a 47-yard football field and a three-story wall of over 750 college football helmets. At the time of this tour, there are 977 players and 211 coaches inducted into the College Football Hall of Fame. Notre Dame University leads the way with 44 inductees. And here is a surprising fact. The most inducted position in the Hall of Fame is the offensive lineman. Below is StateFarm Arena, formerly Phillips Arena. It was constructed in 1999 at a cost of $213 million. Phillips, one of the largest electronics companies at the time, purchased the initial naming rights to the arena in February 1999 for $185 million on a 20-year lease. Due to Phillips' withdrawal from the consumer electronics market, it did not renew its lease, and on August 29, 2018, State Farm purchased the naming rights to the arena, in a deal that will last for 20 years as well and cost $175 million. The arena is owned by the Atlanta Fulton County Recreation Authority and is operated by the NBA's Atlanta Hawks, who serve as the arena's only tenant. The Hawks moved from St. Louis to Atlanta in 1968 and are majority owned by billionaire Tony Ressler, who bought it for $850 million in 2015, along with a group of investors that included NBA Hall of Famer Grant Hill. After a surprise run to the Eastern Conference Finals in 2021, the Atlanta Hawks, led by star Trae Young, are going to be title contenders for years to come. Right next door is the state-of-the-art Mercedes-Benz Stadium. Construction for the stadium began on May 19, 2014, and it opened on August 26, 2017. Construction costs are estimated to have been at $1.6 billion. The Mercedes-Benz Stadium is the home of the NFL's Atlanta Falcons and the MLS's Atlanta United FC. In addition, is the annual host of the SEC Championship Game and the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl. The most unique design aspect is the retractable roof, which, at the push of a button, can allow the stadium to go from a dome to a semi-filled open-air stadium in as little as 8 minutes. Over the past 20 years, Atlanta has been a very influential city in rap music and hip-hop culture. Atlanta has been aptly dubbed the hip-hop center of gravity by the New York Times due to the commercially and acclaimed success of its artists such as OutKast, Ludacris, T.I., Jeezy, Migos, and many more. Ahead is the Trap Music Museum. Founded by rapper T.I., the museum is an interactive experience that uses art to showcase the rich culture of trap music, one of the most popular genres of music today. One of Atlanta's most known rap areas is East Atlanta, and in particular an area known as Zone 6, which has gained massive global exposure due to rap legend Gucci Mane. Other known rappers from East Atlanta include Young Nudy, 21 Savage, Black, and my favorite Atlanta rapper, Future. Our next stop is the National Center for Civil and Human Rights. This museum is dedicated to both the civil rights movement in the United States and the broader worldwide human rights movement. Atlanta played a pivotal role during the civil rights movement of the 1950s and 1960s, And that tradition continues as the city still stands as a powerhouse for modern social justice movements. Just outside of downtown is the Martin Luther King Jr. National Park, which has a number of historical sites, including Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s birth home. Dr. King was born right here at 501 Auburn Avenue in an upstairs middle room on January 15, 1929, and lived here until 1941. Down the street is Ebenezer Baptist Church, where Dr. King was baptized and became an ordained minister at the age of 19. He would co-pastor with his father from 1960 until his assassination in 1968. The church was the site for the funerals for Dr. King and civil rights champion and congressman John Lewis. The park also has the tombs of Dr. Martin Luther and Coretta Scott King. Coretta Scott King chose this location for her husband's tomb because it sits between his birth home and his spiritual home of Ebenezer Baptist Church. More than a million people a year pay their respects to this dignified grave site to honor Dr. King's memory. Make sure to check out our gift shop at www.airworthyprints.com for beautiful posters of the Atlanta skyline for your home, office, or home office. Also, footage from our channel is now available for purchase, so make sure to contact us to find out more.
If you enjoyed today's tour, you can tip your tour guide by hitting the like button. Also, make sure you're subscribed to the channel to be a part of future aerial tours. Thank you for flying with Airworthy Tours, and we look forward to seeing you on our next flight.